Nearly 90 open border activists and illegal aliens sheltered from deportation by the President Obama created Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals program were arrested on Capitol Hill during a pro-amnesty protest. On Monday, DACA illegal aliens and open border activists stormed Capitol Hill demanding an amnesty for the 12 to 30 million illegal aliens living across the United States, despite the negative impact it would have on America's working class and middle class. According to ABC News, 87 illegal aliens and activists were arrested by Capitol Police. Nearly 70 of the 87 arrests were made outside the Capitol, while 19 individuals were arrested inside the Capitol. All of those arrested were hit with obstruction charges, and almost 30 of the activists were hit with an additional resisting arrest charges. DACA illegal aliens and open border activists with the billionaire George Soros-funded group United We Dream stormed the Capitol, saying that the millions of illegal aliens in the United States are entitled to an amnesty. Under a DACA amnesty, American taxpayers would be left with at least a $26 billion bill. About 1 in 5 DACA illegal aliens after amnesty would end up on food stamps, if not already, where at least 1 in 7 would go on Medicaid. Since DACA's inception under Obama, more than 2,100 illegal aliens have been kicked off the program after it was revealed that they were either criminals or gang members. Most recently, a DACA illegal alien was arrested in Rochester, New York, after allegedly threatening to shoot up a nearby high school. Likewise, in October 2017, a DACA illegal alien was arrested and charged with murdering a teenage girl in Greenville County, South Carolina. The illegal alien DACA recipient, Danielle DeSouce Ragnall Scherer, allegedly shot 18-year-old Diana Martinez Gonzalez to death in a wooded area, according to police. This I find absolutely fucking hilarious. Because one, you have these fucking idiots marching and protesting on Capitol Hill, demanding, keyword, demanding that they get amnesty for the 12 to 30 million illegal aliens living in the United States. And that they feel that these illegal aliens are entitled to this amnesty bill. This is what really chokes me up about these people, is that they are here illegally and they think they are entitled for our politicians and our lawmakers and our president to bend over backwards for them and give them whatever the fuck they want. And this is what really bugs me about these illegal aliens living in the United States in the first place. Because they come here, they believe themselves to be somehow holier than thou, a moral beacon of righteousness, and believe that since they're here illegally, that they are entitled to stay here, that they are entitled to be given this amnesty bill, and to be legalized citizens of a country that many of them don't even fucking speak the language of. But they still believe that they are so entitled to these types of laws and regulations. It's bullshit. And how fucking dare they come here, fucking march on all capital, act like a bunch of fucking idiots, and then be expected to be treated like human beings when they're acting like fucking dumbasses, like acting like fucking animals. Protesting, rioting, yelling, screaming, stomping their feet, throwing things like a bunch of fucking children. But not to mention the overly fucking entitlement that these fucking people have. Now, I don't mean to cuss so much, but this really rankles my feathers. They come to this country, they're treated better than American citizens, but yet that is not enough for them. We give them housing, clothing, food. We allow them to work under-the-table jobs which pay them more than the average American citizen gets. We give them an immigration process in order to become legal citizens. They say, fuck that, that's not good enough for us. We just want to come here illegally and then have you people, you the American citizens, you the American politicians, bend over backwards to please us. To give us what we want, because we're entitled, because we are entitled to this amnesty. We are entitled to become American citizens, despite not even liking your country, calling your president a racist bigot, protesting on our capital, and yet they still want to be treated fairly. They still want to be given amnesty. They think they are entitled to this, after treating America, American citizens, American values and American politicians like shit. Now, they can kind of get away with treating the politicians like shit because, well, politicians are shit, and it's the politicians who actually started this whole shabakal in the fucking first place, i.e. Obama and his ilk. But since they got whatever they wanted under the Obama administration, since Obama gave them this entitlement that they believe themselves to be granted, now that Trump is in office and he's not giving them what they want, that's when they want to cry, bitch, and moan and pout their feet. It's no better than a child who you give everything to. The child becomes spoiled. It becomes rotten. And then the child goes, lives with the dad, and the dad has strict rules. How do you think that kid's going to act out? It's going to act out badly because it's not used to rules. It's not used to consequences. It's spoiled. It's a spoiled, shitty fucking kid. And how do you deal with a spoiled, rotten little kid? You beat the fuck out of them. No, I'm joking. No, you give that child strict rules and consequences for its shitty behavior. And this is what Trump's doing to these illegal immigrants. And they don't fucking like it. They don't like it one bit. So they go out and protest. They act entitled. They say, we deserve this amnesty. We are entitled to this amnesty, despite what the fuck have you done? You haven't gone through the immigration process. You just came here illegally and thought, oh, well, I'm not going to be deported because if I'm deported, I can just scream racism and the immigration agents would just let me go. That was essentially the policies and regulation under Obama. Since Donald Trump took office, that has changed. ICE officers are actually deporting a lot of these people, and they don't like it. They're not used to it. They never thought in their wildest dreams that they would have to actually face the consequences of coming here illegally. And this is the consequence. You come here illegally, you're going to get arrested and deported back to wherever the fuck you came from. That is the law in every fucking country. It's not just America. It's not just America who has this evil, horrible idea of an immigration policy and law. In every single country, there is an immigration law. And if you violate that immigration law, you're going to be held accountable. It's just we here in America have been under overly considerate and overly compassionate stupidity politics that people are not used to seeing immigration laws being enforced. Let me give you another example of this. Let's say that the police force and whatnot weren't really enforcing the law against stealing items. You go into a grocery store and steal like a Snickers, a soda bottle, whatever the fuck have you. Since that law isn't enforced anymore, people become used to seeing people steal shit. But then when things start to change up, when the law actually is starting to be enforced, if somebody steals like a donut, they get arrested for it, they get fined for it, people act up. People are not used to seeing this law being enforced. And that is the same thing with the immigration law. Under years of Obama and Bush, the immigration laws were not enforced. Nobody cared about immigration. Nobody even fucking talked about immigration. And that led to millions of these illegal aliens and immigrants believing that they are entitled to stay here, that they will not be deported, that they will not face any consequences for their actions of coming here and violating our immigration laws. Because that is essentially what they have done. They have came here illegally, and they have violated our laws, our regulations, and they believe themselves to be entitled to our amnesty, to our American citizenship. And then when their bad behavior fucking backfires, when they actually hear the music, when they face the consequences, that's when they want to scream bigot. That's when they want to scream racist. But the American population isn't listening anymore. The more these people scream racist, the more people are listening. The word racist has been stretched out so far now that anybody can be racist for any fucking number of things. You eat too much vanilla ice cream, you're a racist. This is how far that word has been stretched. And this does not benefit the left at all, because you can have an actual racist person now actually say something racist, the left calls them a racist for it, that person just says, oh no, you're just an SJW, you're overly sensitive, go cry back to your safe space, and the majority of the population would be like, oh well, probably the left was overreacting again. It's just the left calling somebody that they don't agree with racist. This is how that really backfires on them. But the left is just too stupid to see that. And the minorities who constantly pull the racist card all the time fail to realize that that word racist is stretched out so far now that they themselves can be racist for using racist as a defense. But I am glad to see that these immigrants, these 90 DACA recipients, were arrested, and hopefully, since many of them are actually illegal aliens, actually get deported back to wherever the fuck they come from. But we'll have to see how this really goes, because I would love to see these fucking people get deported. It'll bring me joy. It'll give me a new video to talk about. But I just think it's fucking despicable that they come here and they act so entitled, so belligerent when they don't get their way. And it really does piss me off to really think about that these people that we have sheltered for years under Obama, and all we ask them, all we ask for them is to come here the legal way, go through the immigration process, do the paperwork, pay the fines, go through the process, and get your legal citizenship and residency the right and legal way. That's all we ask for them to do. Apparently, that's too fucking much for them. That's too much of a hassle. It's too much inconvenience on their end. But having 30 million of them automatically legalized in America, fucking over the business classes and middle class people, that's not an inconvenience on them. That actually benefits them. It doesn't benefit us American people. But they don't care about that. They don't care about American values. They don't care about Americans. They just come here and think they can automatically receive the American dream while not caring about the American values, while not caring about American laws and regulations, openly violating immigration laws by being here illegally. And they openly promote themselves, yes, I'm an illegal immigrant. You're damn right I'm an illegal immigrant. Well, what are you going to do about it? Well, we're going to fucking deport you. Oh, you're just a racist. You just don't like seeing anybody who looks different than you. No, I hate seeing people who break the fucking law come here entitled, believing that they are granted amnesty just for being here, just for the sake of offering American citizens their presence. Yeah, no, that's not how the law works. You come here illegally, you violate the immigration laws and policies, you're going to be held accountable. It's not racism. It's not bigotry. It's fucking enforcing the law that has been there, that has always been there. The difference is Obama never enforced the immigration laws. Under Trump, Trump is enforcing these laws. That's why a lot of these illegal immigrants despise Trump. They hate Trump. And the only thing he's doing is enforcing immigration laws. And they don't like that. They don't want that. Well, fuck them. I hope all 90 of these fuckers get deported. Because how dare they come here, march on all capital, and say they are entitled to this amnesty bill. Well, fuck you. You're not entitled to shit. And that's it for this video. Peace out, guys.